Welcome back to Maths class. So this is the class for continuous in sequence and series. Exercise 9.3. So already you complete the last two exercises, and exercise 9.3 also you have completed some questions. Okay. So after that you want to move in this class. Yes, students. Now the exercise 9.3. So for that exercise already we completed. The previous class, I mean the last before the class is 5 sum. In the last class 18 sums almost completed. Now we want to start from the question number 19. Yes, student. So and before that we want to recall the formulas only. Okay, in GP. So what is the general term of GP? A comma A R comma A R square and so going on. And nth term of GP is A n equal to A R power n minus 1. Then sum of n terms of GP is R is, we have three formulas. The first one is R is greater than 1. So F n equal to A into R power n minus 1 divided by R minus 1. And second one is R is less than 1. So that is A, S n equal to A into 1 minus R power n divided by R mi, 1 minus R. Then finally, R is equal to 1 means we have a formula S n equal to N. Yes, student. Now coming to the 19th question and reading the question, listen carefully. Find the sum of the product of the corresponding terms of the sequence 2 comma 4 comma 8 comma 16 comma 32. So they are giving the two sequence, two GPs. So the first GP is 2 comma 4 comma 8 comma 16 comma 32. So totally 5 terms are there in GP. So take us that the sequence is considered by equation number 1. And the next GP is given 128 comma 32 comma 8 comma 2 comma 1 by 2. So take us equation number 2. Yes, student. Now look at the question. What is asking? Find the sum of the product. So first we should multiply the product. Product means what? Multiply. Okay. So equation number 1 multiplied by equation number 2. So how to multiply the mean? See, you have 5 terms of the first GP, first one, and second also you have 5 terms. So I am going to multiply the corresponding terms. First term to first term, second to second, and so like that. Okay. Now 2 into 128, comma, and they are giving the addition also, no, sum, which means plus. Then 4 into 32 plus 8 into 8, then plus 16 into 2 plus finally 32 into 1 by 2. Now I am going to multiply this. So listen. Now it is very simple. 128 2s are 256. Then 32 4s are 64, 128. And 8s are 64. Then 16 2s are 32. So put addition. Why? Because they are asking sum only. So 32. Then finally 32 into 1 by 2 means how to cancel the term like to get plus 16. So this is your record geometric series. So from that series we need to take the two things is very important. So the first one is the first term and second one is the common ratio. And to find the value of the sum of n terms. Sum of n terms, that is Sn. Yes, student. And here how many terms are we having? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1. So n are 5. So take. What are they? Take A equal to 256, then common ratio A in R equal to A2 divided by A1. So the second term is 128 divided by 256 to get R is equal to 1 by 2. So that common ratio is less than 1 or greater than 1. Less than 1. Because half means what? It is less than 1, no? Yes. So which is less than 1. N also given 5. Why? Because of they are giving the two sequence also 5 terms. So we are going to consider N equal to 5. Yes, student. Now Okay, so substitute the value n equal to 5. So S5 which is equal to A. The value of A is 1, so 256. 250. Then R is equal to 1 by 3. Okay, so 1 minus 1 by 2 the whole power n, n mean 5. Whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 2. Yes, student. Okay, now what we are going to do? 256 into 1 minus 1 by 2 the whole power 5. So the power 5 is occupying the both numerator as well as the denominator. Yes, student. So 1 power 5 you get the same thing. What? 1. And 2 power 5. 2 to the 4, 4 to the 8, 8 to the 16. 16 to the 32. 32. Yes, student. So 1 by 32. Whole divided by 1 minus 1 by 2. That is 1 minus half. Half only we have to get it. Yes, ma'am. Okay. Now 256 into 1 by 2 on taking the numerator, it will come on reciprocal. Okay. And you have to subtract by 1 minus 1 by 32. So taking a cross multiply of this, 32 minus 32 into 1, 32. So 32 minus 1 equal to 31 by 32. 31 by 32. Now I'm going to simplify this. 1 2 are 2, 16 2 are 1, 16 are 16. 16, 16 are 16 are 256. Now I'm going to multiply 16 into 31. So 1 6 are 6, 1 1 are 1. 6 3 are 18, remainder 1. 1 3 are the 4. So 6, 9, 4. Yes? So what is your final answer? 496. So S5 is equal to 496. So this is your final answer. Have you got it, children? Because this is different. Why? It means the sum of the product of the terms of two ABs are given. So that one we are going to find the sum. So same this question time, we have one more answer. So the question number 20, the next question. But next question only one small difference. So the difference is, so in this question we have a term in numbers only. Okay, we have a number term, 5 terms, and 5 also is the normal numerals. But the next question you have a different way because of the general term is given. Yes, student. Okay. Now look at the 28th question. Question number 20. Yes? Now what is the given question? Read the question. Show that the product of the corresponding terms of the sequence is given by, so the first sequence is A, comma AR, comma AR square, and so going on, then finally AR power n minus 1. And the second sequence is given to you by A, cap A, comma cap A, and cap A. Why? Because of they are going to compare the two GPs, no. So that's why we need to some differentiation. That's why the first sequence we are giving the small letters and second sequence is capital letter. So A, AR, comma, AR square, comma, and so AR power n minus 1. So take the equation number 1 and that is equation number 2. Okay. Now, so these two also forms an AP. That is also given in the question. Now what they are asking me, find the common ratio. Find the common ratio. So that question also, the same for you in previous one. Okay, so now what we are going to do, multiply 1 by 2. 1 into 2 or 2 into 1 or 2 process is not a problem. See, 1 by equation number 1 and 2 we are going to multiply to get A into A, small A into cap A. The corresponding terms only we are going to multiply. So listen carefully. Okay, in your previous question they are giving only 5 terms. So first term to first term, second term to second term, like that we are multiplying. But here we don't have such number of terms. But we are going to multiply the first to second, third and last term like that. Yes, student? Okay. Now A comma A, I mean A into A comma AR into AR. Differentiate the small in one side and capital in another. And then AR square into AR square. Always we need some differentiation, mean put brackets. is not a problem. A student, okay. Then answer going on. The last term, a r power n minus 1 into a r power n minus 1. A student, okay. Now, so this, what is the resulting product? Product of GP is, the first term is a into a, small a cap a, and second term ar into ar, like that we have one GP. So from that GP, we want to find that which term? Find that common ratio. Find the common ratio. I am going to find the common ratio. That's all. It is the two mark question only student. Common ratio. So common ratio equal to, you know what is that? A2 by A1. Second term divided by first term. To get the second term value is what is that? Small ar into capital ar whole divided by small a into capital A. So we need to cancel the first term only here. So what is your answer? The common ratio, small r, capital R. So this is your final common ratio. Have you got it, children? Okay. And you have the same type of one question. That is question number 24. Yes, student. So the question number 24, you have a homework. Yes. So the same question. But one small thing is, the given question, I read the question just then, show that the ratio of the sum, ratio means what you have to take. Take the numerator one term and denominator one term. Numerator is your sum of first n terms. And say denominator is sum of the terms from n plus 1 to 2n. So students, listen carefully here, we have a n equal to n plus 1 first. Second, n plus 2, n plus 3, and so going on. Finally, we are completing at 2n terms. Okay, so that is your second GP. And we need to check the ratio S1 by S2, which is equal to 1 by R square. So that question, try it yourself. The same map, the same type of this one. Have you got it, children? Okay. And then we want to move to the next question. So next question also very simple. The question number 21. Question number 21. Yes, student. So listen here. Find the four terms of forming that geometric progression. Find the four terms of that geometric progression, which is, what is the given? Yes. Geometric progression which the third term is greater than the first term by 9. And second term is greater than the fourth term by 18. So they are giving the two conditions. The first one is, see, given. Third term, A3, which is equal to A3RP3, you are this. Okay, because they are taking the term, vertical term only. So otherwise, take A and R, BN on both also same, that's your. So A which is equal to what is given means first term greater mean what? Plus. So first term A plus 9. So take the equation number 1 and to simplify the next. Okay. And second thing is given, the second term is greater than by 4th by 18. I mean second term A2 which is equal to 4th term A4 plus 18. So take us equation number. So from that, what we are going to find? See, find the four terms of GP. Find the four terms of GP. Okay, student. So listen here, take the first one and to simplify now. How to simplify? A3. So what is your third term of GP? A comma A R comma A R square like that? No. Yes. So third term is A R square, which is equal to A plus 9. By this, I am taking A in left side to take A R square minus A which is equal to 9. Okay. So this is your first equation simplification. And the second equation I am going to take, what is that? A2 which is equal to A4 plus 18. Okay. So here, see, second term is A R which is equal to fourth term is A R cube plus 18. Yes, student. Now, we want to send it to left side to get AR minus AR cube which is equal to AB. So, take us equation number 4. Okay. So, the simplification of first and second equation. look at this, which one is high? Second only, no?
Yes.
I am going to divide second by first to get AR minus AR cube whole divided by AR square minus A, which is equal to, what is that? 18 by 9. 18 by 9. So look at this, to have anything is common.
Yes.
I have common code in that AR in numerator. So the remaining is 1 minus R square. 1 minus R square. And the denominator also I have common only for A. Okay. So here I am going to take R square minus 1, which is equal to 1 times 9 to 9 is 18. Yes, student. Now here A terms also cancel. And one thing is different. Listen, that is R into 1 minus R square. Hold it up. Here R square minus 1 have no. So I am taking minus outside to get minus of 1 minus R square, which is equal to 2. Now the cancellation of 1 minus R square and 1 minus R square. So the final value of R ratio is this denominator negative, you want to move R, that is minus R, which is equal to 2. R equal to minus 2. R is equal to minus 2. Yes, student. So we are finding the value of the common ratio. And then what we do? Want to take the first term. Yes?
Okay.
So take that equation number 1 or your ratio. I am taking 1, which is, what is that? A R square minus A, which is equal to 9. So that also I am taking A in common on both to get R square minus 1, which is equal to 9. Yes, student. And the next time I am going to substitute the value of R is, what is the value of R? Minus 2. So A into minus 2 the whole square minus 1, which is equal to 9. So A into minus 2 square 4, so 4 minus 1, 3. So A into 3 equal to 9. So the final answer, A is equal to 3. A equal to 3. Now what is the given question? What they asked in the question? Find the first 4 terms of GP. Now I am going to find the 4 terms of GP. So what is your 4 terms of GP? It is very simple. That is A comma, AR comma, AR square comma, AR cube. So these are your first 4 terms of GP. Okay, geometric progression only they ask. So you put a minus one, comma only enough. Suppose geometric series they are asking me, put plus instead of comma. Okay, you have A is 3, comma, AR is 3 into minus 2, and AR square is 3 into plus 4, and AR cube 3 into minus 8. Okay, because minus 2 the whole cube is minus 8. So the final answer is going to be 3 comma, minus 6 comma, 12 comma, minus 24. So this is your final answer for first 4 terms of GP. Yes, student. Have you gotten this term?
Okay.
And next question, you want to move some very important question. So listen carefully. Because that is food sum. But actually very simple only. But you have the same pattern of question you have in miscellaneous exercise also. Yes, student. So listen carefully all of you. If so the question number, question number 22. It is very important. 4 mark question. This is your 4 mark question. Sometime maybe asking by 6 mark, but it is a less for it. See, 22 question number. If the P the term, Q the term, and the R the term of GP are A comma, B comma, C respectively, then we want to prove A power Q minus R into B power R minus P into C power P minus Q, which is equal to 1. Yes, student. Okay. Now I am going to write given. So given is P the term of A, P, R, T, P, which is equal to, what is that? A. And Q the term, A, Q, which is equal to B. Then R the term, A, R, which is equal to, what is that? C. A, R is equal to C. See, A, P, R, T, P, that is your list. On both also, P, P, fifth term, that one. So what we are going to prove is to prove it is a power, what is that? Q minus R into B power R minus E into C power P minus Q, which is equal to
1.
Which is equal to
1.
So students, listen carefully. Here I am going to take a proof, and before that I am going to use the formula of n term of GP. What is the n term of GP? AB, which is equal to AR, which is n term. AN equal to A into R power n minus 1. So like that, I am going to substitute AB, which is equal to A. So for that, A P term, so A R power P minus 1, which is equal to A. So that is equation number 1. Yes, today.
Okay.
And second, Qth term, AQ, which is equal to B. So for that, A into R power Q minus 1 equal to B. So take up equation number 2. And coming to Rth term, AR is equal to C. For that, A into R power R minus 1, which is equal to C. See, students, don't get any confusion from this. Here also R, there also R. This is your common ratio, and that is the term, Rth term. Okay, so don't get any confusion in this. Okay, so we are taking the three terms also. Now, what we are going to prove? What is that? A power Q minus R into B power R minus P into C power P minus P. So I am going to substitute now. So take that left hand side. So left hand side, real matches you have A power Q minus R into B power R minus P into C power P minus P. So for that, I am going to substitute the values of A, B, C from the equation 1, 2, 3. Yes, student. Now, A, value of A is A R power P minus 1, the whole power Q minus R. Yes? So, taking that kind of bracket into, what is the value of B? A R power Q minus 1, the whole power, what is that? R minus P. Again, to the third term is C. C, which is equal to A into R power R minus 1. The whole power, what is that? P minus Q. So students, listen carefully for this question. You have three terms, three brackets, and A into R power P minus 1, the whole power Q minus 1. So I am going to take the powers on both also. Already you studied in your lawyer class. A into B, the whole power M equal to A power M into B power M. Do you know the formula? A into B, the whole power M, A power M into B power. Now what is that? Nothing but this is very simple. We have the take first term also power the same, and the second term also the power same. Now you get the answer for A power Q minus R into R power P minus 1 into Q minus R. Okay, and same like that, second and third also it will come. Into A power R minus P into R power Q minus 1, because you have already Q minus 1 and that is the whole power R minus P. So on both also I am going to multiply R minus P into A power, what is that? P minus Q into R power R minus 1 into P minus Q. Yes, student. So now we are going to multiply as per the correct terms of A and R. See, it is very simple. You have to take the terms of A in one and another R in one.
Okay.
So A, what are they? And you have a formula A power M into A power N, which is equal to A power M plus N. So that formula also you have prepared in your lower classes. Yes, student. So now I am going to substitute. So the values of A is Q power of R minus P, Q minus R minus P, and then P minus P. So these three I am going to combine now. So to get Q minus R plus R minus P plus P minus P. So that's all. So these are the terms of A. a student. And now I'm coming to our power. So I'm going to multiply the terms, the two brackets. Okay, to get P into Q is PQ minus P into R is PR minus PR. Then minus 2 into 1 minus Q. Then minus into minus plus R. Okay, so like this, we are going to get the next two brackets also, four terms. Okay, so listen carefully. So Q into R plus QR plus, what is that? QR plus Q into P minus PQ, sorry, minus PQ, then minus R into 1 minus R, minus PQ, minus is minus, minus is minus plus Q. So these four, all the terms, you have a power solid, so don't get any confusion. Okay, and next, R into P plus PR, R into Q minus QR, minus 1 into P minus B, finally minus 1 into minus Q is plus Q. Now, I'm going to check the terms. Now, the powers of A is, Q you have, plus Q and minus Q cancel, then plus R minus R cancel, plus Q minus Q cancel. So, everything cancel, you get it 0, yes? So, A power 0 into R power, so check it. Here, plus PQ minus PQ are both also cancel. Then plus PR minus PR cancel. Minus Q plus Q minus P. What is that? Plus P is 4. This is plus P. Okay. Then plus R and minus R. Minus QR plus QR. So everything is cancelled. So here also R is 0. So anything power 0, what is the answer? 1. So 1 into 1, 1. So this is your
right side.
Have you got it, children? So this is only important question already I told you. And next question, you want to move by the question number 25. Yes, student? Okay. I hope you all are understand this question. This is very important. So again, I recall you this hand. It is big question. See, given that P the term is A, Q the term is B, R the term is C. R the term is A, R. R is base. Okay. Now what we are going to do? A power U minus R into B power R minus P into C power P minus Q, which is equal to 1. Okay. So I am going to use the formula An equal to A R power N minus 1. So here N is equal to P R. So A R power P minus 1 equal to A. N equal to Q means A R power Q minus 1 equal to B. Then N is R. N is equal to R. So A into R power R minus 1 equal to C. Okay. Now I am going to take the left side and to prove the right side. So take the left side and to substitute the values of A is A R power P minus 1 the whole power Q minus R. And B substitute as request number 2 A into R power Q minus 1 the whole power R minus P. Then finally C equal to you are going to substitute A into R power R minus 1 the whole power P minus 1. So that's what you are going to substitute. Yes, student?
Okay.
And then finally you have to take the separate the terms of A powers and R powers and you are going to multiply to use the formula A power M into A power N, that is A power M plus N, and to cancel R the term to get A power 0 into R power 0, which is equal to 1. So this is your right hand side. Already you get it. Yes, student. And next question, you want to move the same pattern of and want to go the question number 25. So that is also you have the same pattern of the previous one, proving sum. Okay. But actually it is very simple only. Come back that question. Okay. So take your book. Page number is 3. Look at the page number 193. 193. So for that, 193. Which question I am going to do? 25th question. So that is also you have the same pattern. So this one, listen. If A comma B comma C comma D are in GP, what is given? Given A comma B comma C comma D are in GP. Are in GP. Now what we are going to prove is, prove that. Then prove that or show that A square plus b square plus c square into b square plus c square plus d square, which is equal to ab plus bc plus cd the
whole square.
CD the whole square. Yes, student. So listen here. A comma b comma c comma d are in GP. A comma b comma c comma d are in GP. So for that, what I'm going to find prove a square plus b square plus c square into b square plus c square plus d square, which is equal to AB plus BC plus CD the
whole square.
So here I'm going to prove. And before that, you know one thing. You have a GP. Yes, four terms of GP. So I'm going to take the first term of GP A equal to A, and the second term of GP B equal to AR, and third term of GP C equal to AR square. Finally, the fourth term of GP is D equal to KR cube. AR cube. So here, want to take the left side and to prove the term, then multiply and to get the right side. Yes, student. So take the left side. What you have? A square plus B square plus C square into B square plus C square plus D square. Yes, student. So for that, I'm going to substitute the values of A, B, C, D. Yes. What is A? A one in the first term. So A the whole square plus B square is A R whole square. A R the whole square. And C square is what is it? A R square the whole square into B square. What is B square? A R the whole square plus A R square the whole square plus the value of B is A R cube the whole square. Yes, student. So now I'm going to square in the terms of A square, then A square, R square, then A square, R to the 4. Why means A square, A into R square the whole square, so A square, R square the whole square is R to the 4. And then multiply by A square, R square plus A square, R to the 4, because R square the whole square, then A square, R to the 6. Why means R cube the whole square. So look at the first bracket. You have how many terms? What are they? A square. A square only common. So you should take outside. Okay. So A square if you are going to take mean 1 plus R square plus R power 4. Into here what is the common term? You have A square, R square is common. So the remaining, because A square, R square, A square, R power 4, A square, R power 6. So you have a common term from A square for all and R square for all. So A square, R square, you are going to take mean 1 plus R square plus R power 4. Yes, student. Now you are going to multiply the corresponding terms like that. A square into A square, what will come from? A power 4. So A power 4 into R square, because that is not available in the first bracket R. In the first bracket A square and second bracket A square R square. So for that A power 4 into R square. Yes. And see, look at this 2, 1 plus R square plus R power 4. So 2 times if you are going to multiply with to get 1 plus R square plus R power 4 the whole square. Yes, student. Yeah. And see, here you have a A square, A power 4 R square. Shall I take like this? A square R the whole square. A square R the whole square. Into 1 plus R plus R square plus R power 4 the whole square. So for that commonly, I am taking A square R into 1 plus R square plus R power 4 the whole square. The whole power 2. Why? Because of? So the first term also you have a power 2 and second term also you have a power 2. So commonly I am taking moreover. Yes. Now I am going to multiply this first two. A square R plus second term. What is that? A square R power 3 plus third term. That is A square R power 5 the whole square. a student. So for that, what we are going to prove in right side? AB plus BC plus CD. AB means shall we take A into A or A square? Yes or no? So you should take A into A or plus. What is that? BC. So BC means A or into A square. So you have to check it. Okay. A into A square, R into R square, R power 3. Then finally, CD. CD means A R square, the whole A R square into A R power 3. The whole power 2. Yes. So you have a form A B. So A B plus this is B and this is C. Then B C plus here C D plus C D the whole square. So that is your right side. That is your right side. Have you got it, children, this question? It is also very important for marks. Sometimes maybe we will asking to you in by the 6 mark question. Have you got it? So take the left side and to prove the right side. And substitute the values of A equal to A, B equal to A, C equal to A, okay? Then D equal to A, Q. So it is very important thing. We have to substitute the value and taking the square and you have to check which is the common term of the first bracket and then second bracket. And you have to multiply like this. And here, this one, you have some very good concentration you need. Why? Because now you have a square r plus a square r power 3 plus a square r power 5 r. So for that, I'm going to differentiate it. I mean, split the terms of AB, BC and CD like that. And CD like that. Okay? So, so this question I hope you all are understanding. And next question, I am going to move the 2-mark question, 2-mark paper. After that question, this GP topic will finish. GP topic is going to finish by the 2 subject. Yes, student. Okay. So the question number 30 and 31 and 32. So exercise 9.3, page number 193. To have a question 30, 31 and 32. So 30 is a very easy question to you. See, the number of bacteria in certain culture double every year. Yes sir, every hour. So if there are 30 bacteria present in culture of originally, how many bacteria will be present at the end of second hour, fourth hour and nth hour? So what we are going to find? Second hour, which means A2, I mean T2 on both also, and fourth hour, A4, then nth hour, An. So these are the we are going to find. Yes, student. Okay, for that see, in first, how many bacteria are available in here? So let's. So from the information, I am going to take the first term and common term. Yes, student. Okay. So take solution. Take the first term. A equal to 30. Why? Because you have a 30 bacteria present in culture. Present at present. First, you have 30 bacteria. And then only the bacteria is increased. How mean? Doubles. Doubles mean what? Multiply by 2 on power 2 on, which is doubles every hour. So r equal to 2. So from the information, what you are taking? A equal to 30 and r equal to 2. Okay, have you got it? And the next, I am going to find the number of bacteria end of 10th hour. So number of bacteria at end of second hour, fourth hour and nth hour. Nth hour. So that only we are going to find. So second hour means A2, second hour. So second hour means A2 means what you have a formula? AR square. Because doubles only know. So that's why I am taking 30 into 2 the whole square. To the whole square. Because 2 power 1 is the first term. Okay. And this one is you are going to multiply. See, look at this. You have a final answer in your book pad. So that is also you have a original number, the full number only coming. Yes. So like that, you have to take 30 into 4, which is equal to 120. So 120 bacteria at the end of second year, and then take 4 tar, that is 30 into 2 power 4. So 2 power 4 means what will come to them? 2 dose of 4, 4 dose of 8, 8 dose of 16. Okay. So 16, 3 tar 48. So 480 bacteria at the end of what year? 4 tar. Then finally, I am coming to find that nth tower. So nth tower means an, which is equal to ar power n minus 1. What is that? An equal to ar power n minus 1. So for that, every year, so that is 30 into 2 power n only. Here, we don't want to substitute n minus 1 like that. Why? Because of every r, you know, it is doubles only, no? So that's why I am taking this only, n not 30 into 2 power n. So this is enough to you to find. Okay. Have you got this, children? Then the last question I am going to give you for this class. Question number 31. So this question is also, we want to recall our 8th question. Okay. You have a simple interest and compound interest formula. So like that only we are going to do. So look at that machine. What will rupees 500 amount into in 10 years after its deposit in a bank, which pays annual interest rate of 10% compounded annually? Okay, so by the data, what you are going to take? The three things. Can you remind the formulas? Simple interest, SI, simple interest, or I, which is equal to PNR by 100 or PRT by 100. P is the principal, R is the rate of interest, and T is the time. Okay. Or PNR by 100 also the same. N is number of hours. Okay. So I mean number of years. Okay. And coming to the compound interest, that is first we need to find the amount. A equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power N. And then only we are going to find the compound interest CI, which is equal to A plus or P plus E, like that. Okay, so here 31 question number, they are given that concept principal P is equal to rupees 500, and the n number of years equal to 10 years. Then finally the rate of interest R is equal to given 10%. R is equal to given, it is 10%. Yes, student. Now we are going to take a compounded annual formula. Compounded annual formula. So this formula you have in your 8th syllabus. Okay. So you want to recall the amount A is equal to P into 1 plus R by 100 the whole power N. Yes, student. So you have a principal 500 rupees. So 500 into 1 plus you have a rate of interest 10%. So 10 by 100 the whole power N is equal to 5. So for that I am going to simplify it. 10 are cancelled. So 500 into 1 plus 1 by 10 the whole power 5. So for that 1 by 10 means 0.1 shall we take like that? So here 500 into 1 plus 0.1 the whole power 5. Now finally 500 into 1.1 the whole power 5. 1.1 we need to find multiply 5 terms and to multiply 500. It is some bigger work, so we don't want to do because it is 2 mark question like that. 2 mark or 1 mark. So we need only this is your answer. So that answer only is given to you as a back question. Yes, student. So today class is going to complete now. And so this for that class, how many questions are we counting there? 19 to continuously 25. Okay, and 30, 31. So you have a pending question 26, 27, 28, 29, 32. So this question you have pending, and before that you should know the arithmetic mean and geometric mean. And what is the relationship between AM and GM? So this and all we are going to see the next class. Okay, so you need to complete the homework from example today. Examples number 11, 12, 13, 14. So these are the already agreed. 14, 15 also already agreed. Now 16 question only enough. Okay. So this class is going to complete. So complete your homework. Okay. And then we will see the next class. Thank you.